Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Do you have the same experience when you travel in Japan with group tours? All you can do is sleeping on the bus, taking the photos and shopping all the time, no matter you want or not. Being a backpacker is totally different. You can set the whole journey and go wherever you want. But without tour guides, will we travel like fighting? No, take it easy. Today, I will tell you some useful tools when you travel in Japan your own. First, you have to make sure what your purpose is. For example, my purpose is tourism factory and the museum. Then, go to the backpacker website to search the similar information from others. My suggestion is, check at least two or three same information to make the details are correct. Don't trust the travel book only. Second, choose the hotel to stay. Normally, there are three types you can choose. From the higher to lower price are hotel, homestay, and hostel. Each of them has advantages and disadvantages. It depends on how much budget you have and your personal habit. According to my experience, in the center of the big city, there are still some good hotels with good price. Third, you have to know how to take bus or train. There is a very useful website called Ikikara. Key in the station name you want to get on and get off and the date and what time you like to take, it can count for you the best solution. No matter the lowest price or the shortest time. It also can tell you which line you should take and when you change to another line, how many minutes will it take by walk. When you get all the information, you can check if through pass ticket can help you saving money. But you must remember that if the ticket can help you saving money, it's worth. Be careful. There are many seductive coupons coming with the ticket. Don't let the coupon change your plan and waste your time. After going out from the station, you may not tell the right direction, so you have to ask. A successful opening is very important. As a foreigner, here is my example story for you. When I walked to Asahi Beer Factory, I didn't know where I should turn right as the map, so I had to ask. I saw a gentleman walking to me with business suit, look like good at English. So I ran to him and said, "Excuse me." This gentleman raised up his hand and walked quickly. Okay, maybe my opening is not suitable, so I decided to use a Japanese style opening. This time I saw a mother walking to me with a baby car. I ran again and said, "Sumimasen." This mother saw me and ran faster. 对不起,我听不懂日文. Of course, I got the answer. When you know how to ask, how to take an order is important too. My friend and I went into a restaurant. She wanted a cup of hot milk. So she said, "Hot milk, please." But the waitress couldn't understand what she said. So I asked her, let me do it. Hot dog? Who? Hi. After lunch, we walked into a shop store. My friend wanted to buy XL size socks. So she told the shop assistant, "XL size, please." But the assistant couldn't understand what she said. So I asked her again, let me do it. Size, XL. Hi. Can you see? Travel in Japan is not difficult at all. Japanese are friendly and good-mannered. The young generation in Japan has better education in English. Some of them even study abroad for a long time. Also, some Japanese characters are Chinese too. It's easy to understand. And the best is, Taiwanese don't need visa. That is why I like being a backpacker in Japan. Contest master.
Winnie, your speech is just like your kimono. Long enough to cover everything and colorful enough to attract our attention. Your speech divided into two parts. One's information, that of being a backpacker. The second is very entertaining dialogue. I like those dialogues. So your story has different special characters and dialogues all combined in this speech. I was really attracted by all your speech plus your kimono. And then for such speech, I couldn't help to wonder, can we add more color in this speech? I would suggest that in the opening, because this kind of joyful topic, also informative, you might use some music and bring a bag behind you with an umbrella and dancing like that. I'm wearing kimono going to Japan. And in your body, I hope you can feel big. Why? The stage is big, the crowd is big, the room is big. So your voice tends to be soft. Sometimes, why don't you be a little bit silly? Dramatic. You say, Saizu, Ekosu, or Nani? Then pause, prolong the pause to cover whole room and audience. Of course, the dialogue part, your delivery was excellent by doing those characters. And the last part is what I really concern is WIIS. Every audience like to hear your story, but they will wonder, what's in the story for me? What's in there for me? Being a backpacker in Japan, so they want to hear more. And then I would suggest at the end, you can deepen the value. Because everybody knows, in Chinese, they say, instead of reading 1 million books, why don't you travel 1 million miles? So that means traveling can really experience different culture, different country, so can really enrich your life. With that, I would suggest at the end, you hold the backpack again. Just like a traveler, a good agent will bring the traveling to the final destination, that's home. Your opening, because you say, instead of sleeping in the bus, why don't you walk, learn by yourself in a backpacker? So all in all, you can, at that moment, you can call for action, right? So, interesting story. If, and most colorful, joyful opening, and feel the beat at the party, at the end, bring out the meaning and call for action, say, hey, now are you ready to add color to your life? Go to Japan, let's go! Sayonara! No, Ohio.
Winnie, I'd like to start by asking, has anyone ever told you how hot you look in a kimono? Wow. I bet you there's a lot of guys out there that were just drooling. Fellow Toastmasters and Contest Chair, as I analyze Winnie's speech, I'd like to start with Triple W. I want to tell you what I like, why I liked it, and why I liked Winnie. The first thing I liked was the way that you set the atmosphere. From your first bow to your characterizations of the typical stereotypes of the Japanese people to the pictures, the masterful use of the PowerPoint, I felt like I was in Japan. The atmosphere you set was so good that I could even almost smell the sushi and the miso soup. So great job with the atmosphere. Number two, your speech was an informational speech and your pace was wonderful. I felt very comfortable. I was grasping what you were saying. The use of PowerPoint was masterful, just the way PowerPoint should be used. It enhanced your speech and it was not a central point. The pictures, the tickets, all that helped us understand. Number three, the humor was great. My favorite story was when you asked the mother pushing the baby, and she answered in Chinese. The surprise element caught us, and it brought a great laughter with everybody. Now, for my recommendations, let me stick on the humor. I was sitting there, and Emily Murray, well-known Laowai, was sitting to my left, and when you said the Chinese punchline, she didn't even laugh. Emily? Well, you're in an international setting. You're doing your speech in English. I would recommend that you add the English translation to your punchline. It would be more meaningful to those who might not have understood it. Then, when you came to your conclusion, you had me cruising along in a train in Japan, and all of a sudden, boom, you stopped. Do you realize that you only took 5 minutes and 7 seconds? You had lots of time left. You could have brought a very good conclusion. Now, a conclusion is where we take the audience back down the memory lane of our speech. And you had plenty of time to do that. You could have brought the conclusion. Now, in summary, before you go to Japan, do your research, learn some Japanese, and next time you go, you will be able to enjoy it like I did. Something like that. So, in my conclusion, build on your strengths. You have just a wonderful natural voice. People felt so comfortable, and you're a great instructor. Number two, remember the humor side. Add in translation if you're in an international setting. Number three, bring it to a good conclusion. Take the audience down memory lane. So my last question, Winnie, is next time you go to Japan, could I please come with you? Okay.
Contest here. Ladies and gentlemen, do you want to have a backpack trip to Japan now?
Yes.
See, Winnie, what an attractive speech you've just done. And I can see your passion of sharing this information with all of us through your dressing. That was so convincing. In addition, I really enjoy your clear organization of having the useful 5 tips. It's really easy for me to understand and memorize them. And besides, I really like your humor, especially the part you ask for direction. Lastly, I really like your natural performance, especially your facial expression. That was so good. Now, in order to help you improve, here are my suggestions. First, in terms of the content, the benefit. It was good for you to mention the benefit of being a backpacker. But why Japan? Actually, you answered that as your close sentence. I would suggest you to say something similar to that and put it in the opening. So after we know the benefit of being a backpacker in Japan, we'll be dying to know how. Secondly, relate to the audience at the opening. You can do that just by asking them, do you want to travel to Japan? I have a better way. And lastly, call them for action at the closing. Just call them to pack your bag, fly to Japan tomorrow. And next, in terms of the organization, the balance. Right now, you have 5 different points, and you only gave story at the last one about the effort direction. But I would suggest if you give stories and examples for each point so we can all understand each point more clearly. And second is the transition. Now you have, Winnie, you have 5 separated points. I would suggest to bridge them in a more effective way. Like after your point one, you can say, now we have a purpose to go to Japan, but next we have to find a place to stay there. And lastly, regarding to your delivery. Right now, you only limited yourself at this part of the stage. But since we have a larger audience and larger stage, I've suggested to cover the whole stage and walk wider. For example, plant your feet at the point of the stage, talk to the audience with confidently eye contact. And next is the emotion. You have a strong voice, which is very good. I suggest you add more emotion. For example, when you fail at the first time you ask for direction, you would like to hear more disappointed. But in summary, Winnie, you did a really wonderful job. Just keep working on the suggestions I made. In the near future, you will be one of the best speakers in our district. Don't you guys agree?
Yes!
Contest here.